Today, we're going to understand the concept of projectile motion. Do you know what a projectile is? Why does it follow a parabolic path? Well, let's find out the answers to these questions in this video. An object that is projected with a certain angle relative to the ground is called a projectile. The path followed by the projectile is called the trajectory. When the object is projected at 0 degrees relative to the surface of the ground, parallel to the ground, the scenario is called horizontal projection. In this projection, the object follows a parabolic path while falling onto the Earth's surface. Similarly, when the object is projected at any angle between 0 degrees and 90 degrees relative to the surface of the ground, the scenario is called oblique projection. In this projection also, the object follows a parabolic path while falling onto the Earth's surface. We usually study projectile motion in the absence of air resistance or drag force. This means the only force involved in the study of projectile motion is the force due to the gravity of the Earth. But when drag force or air resistance is involved, it is necessary to consider the acceleration produced by these forces too. Vertical projection is a rectilinear motion, whereas horizontal projection and oblique projection are considered as projectile motion. Let's discuss the projectile motion of an oblique projectile. The object is projected at an initial speed of V0 at an angle theta above the horizontal, as shown in the figure. As the object is projected with some angle relative to the horizontal, the launch velocity can be resolved into two perpendicular components. V0x equals V0 cosine theta and V0y equals V0 sine theta. Since there is no air resistance or drag force in this scenario, the net force in the horizontal direction is zero. Thus, the horizontal acceleration is zero, ax equals zero. This means the horizontal component of velocity is constant along the path. The only force involved in our discussion is the force due to gravity, which always acts towards the center of the Earth that is downwards. This means the acceleration due to gravity is applicable to the projectile motion. Since there is vertical acceleration, the vertical component of velocity changes with time. As the acceleration due to gravity is acting downwards, the vertical component of velocity gradually decreases during its ascent, and it becomes zero at the maximum height position. On the other hand, during the descent, the vertical component of velocity increases gradually. As the object in the considered case only experiences acceleration due to gravity, the projectile motion can be considered as motion under uniform acceleration. So, all the kinematic equations, such as the equations given below, are applicable. The variables used in the above equations are xi and xf are the initial and final positions of the projectile along horizontal axis. yi and yf are the initial and final positions of the projectile along vertical axis. V0x and V0y are x and y components of initial velocity, launch velocity. Vx and Vy are x and y components of the velocity after time, t. Ax and Ay are x and y components of the acceleration. Minus sign is used for g, because the acceleration due to gravity acts downward direction. Take upward positive and downward negative. Take the origin always on the ground at the point of projection or below the point of projection for making the calculation simple. In this video, we have understood what is projectile and discussed the path followed by a projectile. If you are asked to find the time that the projectile is in the air, maximum height reached by the projectile, and the horizontal range covered, then use suitable kinematic equations for both horizontal and vertical directions, and try solving the equations to obtain the required expressions.